Mr. Secretary of State, could you please place your hand on the Bible? Could you repeat after me? Could you raise your right hand? I, state your name.
Jesse White.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support.
That I will support.
The Constitution.
The Constitution.
Of the United States.
The United States.
And the Constitution.
And the Constitution.
Of the State of Illinois.
The State of Illinois.
And that I will faithfully discharge.
That I will faithfully discharge.
The duties of the office.
The duties of the office.
Of the Secretary of State.
The Secretary of State.
To the best of my ability.
To the best of my ability.
So help me God. The Secretary of State. Congratulations, sir.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'd like to thank Governor Rahner, Lieutenant Governor Sangarinetti, Attorney Lisa Madigan, Treasurer Ferrix, Comptroller Munger, distinguished guests, families, and friends. I'm humbled and proud to be here today to continue to serve the people of Illinois. Our state has had its fair share of negative headlines and have had some bad apples who have taken the oath of office. But I can assure you that the overwhelming majority of the people I have had the distinction of, and privilege of serving with have served with honor and distinction. For those people I want to mention today, Governor Pat Quinn has served our state with honor and distinction. Whether working as a consumer advocate, supporting our veterans, or leading the state as governor, he has always put people first. As governor, he inherited a mess, and I'm proud to say that he took the tough stand to bring honor back to Illinois. I was proud to work with him. Comptroller Judy Bartopinka was a trailblazer. She was a straight shooter, and we worked together in the Illinois General Assembly, and she dedicated herself to making sure that not only did she take on the job, but she also took on the responsibility that goes with it. She did all she could to help make our state a better place for all of us. I was fortunate to work with her directly in the Illinois General Assembly and again as a constitutional officer. Although we were from different political parties, we always respected each other and worked for the common good. I miss my friend Judy. Illinois is a better state because of the life's work of these two special people. Like Pat Quinn, Judy Bartopinka, and many others, I've always considered public service to be an honorable profession, one that comes with incredible responsibility and one that I take very seriously. The people of Illinois have trusted me with their confidence and support to continue my agenda in the Secretary of State's office. It's a responsibility that I have never and will never take for granted. Since 1999, when I became the first Secretary of State sworn in this office, I focused my work to restore integrity, to make the office more efficient and customer friendly, and to make our roads safer. And I am also proud of the fact that we have made great strides in each of these important areas. I want to thank my good friend, Jim Burns, who is the former U.S. Attorney for the Northern District of Illinois, who has made my mandate to restore integrity to this office a reality. Together, we drafted and passed legislation that created the Office of the Secretary of State Inspector General. And Jim has made that office a national model. For as long as many of us can remember, visiting the DMV was one chore that many of us would like to avoid. I think, in fact, many of us would rather go to the dentist's office rather than to the DMV. Long lines, inefficiency, and questionable public service were not what the people of Illinois deserved. It was so bad, many told me in 1999 that I would never be able to improve the office, and I shouldn't waste my time in trying. Well, to those who know me, it's never a good idea to say that I can't achieve. Those long lines that once wrapped around the building are gone. No longer do you have to go to our DMV and bring your duffel bag, sleeping bag, or your lunch pail. We try to get you out as quickly as we possibly can. And through the implementation of new technologies, the office is streamlined and efficient. And through training and retraining, customer service is job one. To be sure, my job is not done, and we will be rolling out new initiatives that will further improve the once dreaded visit to the DMV. The Illinois Secretary of State's office is the largest of its kind in the nation, and it touches more lives than any other office in government. And we have streamlined our services throughout the agency. We reformed the truck driving licensing program and improved our services for businesses and lobbyists and investors. We offer better opportunities for those who visit libraries throughout the state, and we have made it easier for victims of crime to be compensated. Our organ donor program is a national model, and our state archives protects our rich history. I am proud of these accomplishments, but I am practically proud of the fact that we have really enjoyed great success in the area of road safety. Jim Edgar once told me that he dreaded to hear news reports of road fatalities caused by an individual he licensed. This job is serious. Lives are at stake, and that's why we're working hard to make our roads safer. We have toughened our DUI laws, which are now considered the best in the country. Our efforts have resulted in reducing drunk driving fatalities by 60% since 1999. But we didn't stop there. Nationally, the leading cause of deaths for teens is traffic crashes. Tragically, in a 15-month period of time between 2005 and 2006, 15 teenagers in Tazewell County lost their lives on Illinois roads. I was heartbroken and I was angry. As Secretary of State, I needed to do something about it. I created a task force made up of legislators, educators, law enforcement officers, judges, and traffic safety experts from around the state and the country. Together, we revamped the licensing program for new teen drivers. We acquired more training, extended the length of the learner's permit, and enhanced the penalties for failing to comply with the program. The result, teen drivers in Illinois have dropped by nearly 55%. That's good, but let's be clear, I'm not satisfied. One death is one too many, and that's why I am reconvening our traffic safety task force to further improve the road safety initiatives. Many of you know about my career as a lawmaker, educator, professional athlete, paratrooper, county, and state official. And over the past 55 years as a founding coach of the Jessie White tumbling team, am proud that through my program, over 15,000 young people were given an opportunity to contribute to society and live long and productive lives. I believe that when you come through this world and you become successful, you must give back. I also believe that every day you should do something good for someone. Our future rests with our young people. I say this is not to brag, but to acknowledge those people who have had a significant impact on my life, which has allowed me to succeed and to give back to others. Most of them you may not be familiar with, but each played an important role in my life. People like Warren Chapman, who helped me to get a scholarship to Alabama State College. Claude Walton, who taught me baseball. Ben Schoenfeld, who taught me to be a gymnast. Fred Ross, my basketball coach. Iron Man McInnes, a gentleman who taught me about life. Professor Lockhart at Alabama State College. Alonzo Krim, a principal of an elementary school. Pete Reeser, professional baseball player. Rip Collins, professional baseball player. Alvin Tappy from Peoria, Illinois, or better yet, Quincy, Illinois. The Honorable George W. Dunn and my former minister, Dr. Martin Luther King. My parents, Jessie White Sr. and Julia White, will always be my true heroes and inspiration. I thank all of them and so many others who have helped me along the path. In closing, I want to thank my family, friends, for joining me today, and to thank my staff led by Tom Benigno, the greatest Roman of them all, for his dedication and loyalty. Without them, I could have not been able to carry out my aggressive agenda. I congratulate my fellow constitutional officers and members of the Illinois General Assembly. Governor Rahner, I congratulate you, sir, and you can rest in the knowledge that I am committed to working with you to help make Illinois a better place for all of us. To the people of Illinois, I want to remind you that I served my country as a paratrooper with the 101st Airborne Division. As they would say, when you jump out of a perfect airplane, you never worry about the jump. It's a sudden stop. And then when you jump out of an airplane, it's all the way, not halfway. That's how I run my life. I will never quit. And ladies and gentlemen, that's why I want to thank you for giving me an opportunity to serve you. And as they would say in my neighborhood, ladies and gentlemen, Jessie White is here to share with you his experience and commitment to serving the people of the state of Illinois in a manner in which they can richly deserve and can appreciate. I am reporting for duty.